Hello friends, this is Professor Harshad Marathe. Today I'll be speaking about a new subject that has been introduced in second year of Diploma. This subject is known as DBMS or Database Management Systems. Now, this subject covers various topics such as introduction to relational database management systems, basic SQL queries, advanced SQL queries, and PL/SQL programming. Today I'll be covering two short topics from this subject. The first topic is asset properties, which I have written here, and the second topic is states of transaction, which I have drawn here. Before beginning, I would like to introduce a simple concept in database management systems. This concept is named transactions. A transaction is nothing but a collection of various queries that are executed on a database. These queries have to be executed as a group. This means that either all queries will be executed or none of the queries will be executed. Let's take the example of withdrawing cash from an ATM machine. While withdrawing cash from an ATM machine, there are various queries that execute on a database. For example, checking if the customer has correctly entered the PIN, checking if the amount entered by the customer is correct, checking if that amount is present within the account of the customer, then subtracting that amount from the account of the customer, and then successfully dispensing the cash. Now, either all these subqueries have to run successfully or none of them should run. It cannot happen that half the set of queries will run and half of them will not run. The property which ensures that either the entire transaction completes successfully or the entire transaction is not allowed to complete at all, that property is known as atomicity. Atomicity will ensure that either all the subqueries of the transaction will run successfully or none of them will run. If only half of them have run successfully and the remaining half have failed, then whichever queries have run successfully will be rolled back so that the database will be in a state previous to that of when the transaction began. The second property is consistency. This property ensures that the database remains in a consistent state after the transaction has ended. For example, if the account of the customer had a balance of 50,000 rupees before the transaction began, the database management system should ensure that the account balance does not go below rupees 0 after the transaction has ended. This is because any customer account cannot have a negative balance. So this property, consistency, ensures that the database will remain in a consistent state even after the successful execution of a transaction. The third property is isolation. This property is necessary when multiple transactions may be simultaneously running on the database. For example, there may be two ATM machines located beside each other and two different customers may be withdrawing cash from their respective accounts using these two machines simultaneously. So there are two transactions going on at the same time. Now, one transaction should not be able to figure out any details about the other transaction, which means that both transactions should be completely isolated from each other. This property is known as isolation, and it is the responsibility of every relational database management system to ensure these properties. The fourth property is durability. This property ensures that after the transaction has successfully completed, all the changes made by that transaction should become permanently committed within the database and should never be rolled back. These four properties, which are present in a relational database management system, are known as asset properties. Now, we'll see the various states in which every transaction can be. For example, let's take the same example of withdrawing cash from an ATM machine. Let's say I am currently at an ATM machine and I am entering my credit card PIN in order to withdraw the amount. So currently the transaction is in active state. The transaction has just begun and it is in active state. It is currently executing. For example, suddenly if the network fails, so it will go in another state which is known as failed state because a fault has occurred. Since a fault has occurred, it has entered into the failed state and it has now to be rolled back so that it can be considered as an aborted transaction. So this is known as the failed state, and after the failed state, all the SEP queries of the transaction which were completed are rolled back so that it goes back to the aborted state. Now, while the transaction is executing, if it reaches the final statement of the transaction or the final query, it is known as partially committed. Once the transaction is partially committed, it is almost successful. But there is yet a probability that the network can fail even at this point of time. If that happens, another fault occurs and the transaction fails. Even in this case, all the queries that have executed successfully have to be rolled back so that the transaction will be aborted. Now, if the transaction is partially committed, which means all the sub-steps of the transaction or the sub-queries have executed successfully, and finally the network is connection is proper, the transaction is finally committed, successful, it enters into the committed state, and all the changes made by transaction are permanently stored in the database. After the transaction enters the committed state, there is no operation which can undo or roll back the changes made by the transaction. So these are two simple topics in the subject database management system. These topics will be covered in the subject in Vidyalankar. So students, for more details on this subject, be sure with Vidyalankar. Thank you very much.